environmental risk of water bodies in the conditions of mineral deposits development. Natalia Sherstiuk, Privy State Pedagogical University. The growth of humanity's needs set the global task of providing food with the necessary caloric content and composition, water of an acceptable quantity and quality, territory that provides many aspects of human activity, energy that does not cause global geo-ecological crises, and products of industrial activity that do not lead to an unacceptable level of environmental pollution. These needs are steadily growing, moving the ecosphere from a crisis, but still stable state to an unstable one, and with further development of instability, to a global catastrophe. The mining activity of the region significantly affects their sustainable development. It can be a source of employment for local residents, a source of state income, an engine of economic growth and development of remote areas. However, significant environmental impacts and inequitable distribution of economic benefits can exacerbate instability and cause conflict. Each problem of the mining industry is local, but the fundamental issues of mining in the relevant format are international in nature. Sustainable mining is a theoretical and highly unlikely goal to achieve. Metals and minerals are non-renewable resources, and the rate of decline is going to be greater than the rate of depletion. From a practical perspective, achieving sustainability in the mining industry is a distant prospect, but many mining companies and industry associations are moving towards more economically, environmentally and socially responsible business practices. Mining invariably benefits people and harms the environment. At the stages of their extraction and processing, numerous environmental problems arise. First of all, during the extraction and processing of minerals, a large geological cycle is disrupted, in which various systems are involved. As a result, there is a great impact on the ecology of the mining region, and such an impact has negative consequences. Impact of mining on the lithosphere. The development of deposits of dense rocks is accompanied by significant extraction of forested and agricultural lands. Possible activation of geological processes karst, landslides, scree, subsidence and displacement of rocks. During underground mining, subsidence pits and sinkholes are formed. Mechanical disturbance of soil sand their chemical pollution. Impact of mining on the atmosphere. As a result of the processes of primary processing of mined ores, large volumes of mined methane, sulfur, and carbon are emitted into the air. In addition, a large amount of dust enters the air during mining. When 1,000 tons of explosives are used, about 40 million cubic meter of atmospheric air is polluted, exceeding the limit of permissible concentrations tenfold, and its spread is possible over 15 kilometers. Impact of mining on the hydrosphere. The development of mineral deposits by an open method causes not only the degradation of the Earth's surface in the area of mining operations, but also a sharp change in hydrological and hydrogeological conditions, which lead to a change in the quality of surface and underground waters. As a result of the extraction of natural raw materials, reservoirs and underground waters are depleted, swamps are drained. Assessment of the ecological situation of a certain region or the entire country is an urgent task today. Environmental risk has an important place in the environmental assessment of the current or projected situation. Environmental risk, at all levels, from local to global, assessment of the likelihood of negative changes in the environment caused by anthropogenic or other influences. It is important to note that any economic activity always has an environmental risk. For water bodies, ecological risk is the probability of undesirable consequences in water ecosystems and their components as a result of anthropogenic and natural factors, including a decrease in water quality. Several methods of ecological risk assessment have been developed and used both for individual regions and river basins, as well as for certain sections of rivers subject to anthropogenic pressure. This study used the method of environmental risk assessment according to the formulas. Used in formula C is the concentration of the different pollutant, DP, that exceeds the threshold limit value, TLV, N is the total number of DP analyzed, content greater than TLV and less. The results of hydrochemical observations on the territory of the Northern Iron Ore Dressing Works, Kuriri, which were conducted by the state enterprise Ukraine Geology, were used to assess the environmental risk. The water objects of the natural technogenic complex of Northern Iron Ore Dressing Works include the tailings storage facility and a section of the Saxahan River, ponds and man-made water objects. The Northern Iron Ore Dressing Works tailings pond has been in operation since 1963. In addition to sludge bulk, quarry water, 2.5 million cubic meters/year, mineralization mine water, 5.5 million cubic meters/year, wastewater from treatment plants 36.15 thousand cubic meters/year, and precipitation are discharged into the tailings pond, and surface filtration waters that were made from drainage systems built around the storage. Preliminary studies have established that a persistent geochemical and hydrochemical anomalies has formed on the territory of the Northern Iron Ore Dressing Works. The center of the anomalies is a tailings, which ponds water has an elevated content of microcomponents, lead, cadmium, vanadium, bromine. The content of some microcomponents also has an increased in the water of the River Saxahan and in the water of the pond in Nevoda. The results of the ecological risk calculations of water bodies on the territory of the Northern Iron Ore Dressing Works are presented in slide. According to the results of the calculations, it can be concluded that in general the ecological situation in the water bodies of the Northern Iron Ore Dressing Works is deteriorating. The greatest concern is the too high content of bromine, both in the water of the tailings pond and in the water of water bodies. Let me remind you that bromine belongs to the second class of danger. Bromine is a chemical element that is energetically accumulated by plants, animals in landscapes. An excess of bromine in the human body leads to a decrease in the concentration of iodine and the hormones of the thyroid gland, hyperthyroidism, and also contributes to the rapid release of chloride ions by the kidneys. The main source of bromine in the tailings pond is mine water. Among the heavy metals, an increased content of lead and vanadium is always noted, which enter the water of the tailings pond and the water of surface water bodies from the enrichment tails. Among the studied natural and man-made water bodies, the greatest ecological risk is noted in the tailings stope air -2.53 as of the 5th of April 2020. It should be noted that over time the ecological risk increases in the tailings stope air and in the pond Nevoda. In the Saxahan River, changes in environmental risk values over time do not have a clear dependence. This is due to the fact that the hydrochemical regime of the river is formed under the influence of not only man-made but also natural factors. It should also be noted that information for assessing the environmental situation in Krivkas is not publicly available. Therefore, in order to achieve world standards in the field of mineral extraction according to the criteria of sustainable development, Ukrainian companies still need to pay a lot of attention to the issues of openness of information about nature protection. Conclusions. The mining industry has a significant effect on the ecological state of water bodies, which is confirmed by the calculated value of ecological risk. It was determined that the water of the tailings storage has the greatest environmental risk -2.53 on the 5th of April 2020, the Saxagan River 0.17 on the 19th of March 2014 has the lowest. The magnitude of ecological risk increases over time in almost all water bodies. The proposed method of calculating environmental risk for water bodies can be used to analyze the effectiveness of environmental protection measures and sustainable development of mining areas.